Hi, this is Pauline here. It's October 16th, Friday. A lot of stuff has gone on, and we got back on Monday from our two-week trip up to Vermont, which was wonderful. It was really great. I did a little video up in Vermont about the road trip up there, and just the countryside was gorgeous all the way up. The only thing that was, you know, the only thing that marred the countryside were, you know, Trump signs. And again, like I've mentioned before, I think people have the right to, you know, freedom of expression and show who you support. And it's important for the rest of us to see that, to know who you support so that we can avoid you. Because, you know, some of us actually recognize human rights as a legitimate thing. And not toxic and gross, which is something my sister calls people who respect human rights. That's toxic and gross. So, yeah, that's what we're doing. That's where we're going. But here's the thing, you know, I want to talk about a couple of things. So there was this paper that came out, a study through the CDC, that was looking at masks and who wore them and who didn't wear them and what were the results of that. And apparently the Federalist paper decided that they were going to hire some recent grad to write about it, and this person cherry-picked a bunch of information out of this this research paper and decided that, oh look, see, masks don't work. And that's actually the opposite of what this study showed. Complete opposite. So, for example, I'm going to read a little outtake of a blog post by an actual journalist who teaches journalism. And she or he, I'm not sure, they write that students often ask why they need to take statistics for a degree in journalism, and that this article is patient zero for that answer, the article in the Federalist. Why do students of journalism need statistics? Is because when you're reading a research paper that includes a lot of statistics and numbers, and I'm really not great with that sort of thing because I don't do math. You know, dyscalculia doesn't help. But I know enough not to be the person that's going to write an article about a statistical research paper, unless I get help from someone who does do math, like Guy, who does math really well, and he's a scientist, and he can understand those things. But if I don't understand it, I'm not going to write a paper like this person did, and has completely duped people who are anti-mask and think that this virus is a complete hoax. Like the president right now, who got corona because he doesn't wear a mask, and his whole family got it because they don't wear masks. The thing is, the study shows that this article comes from Jordan Davidson of The Federalist, an online conservative publication that covers a variety of topics, including politics, art, and culture. Its previous coverage on COVID-19 has been labeled, quote, pseudoscience, and criticized for its scientific content coming from, quote, writers not known for the epidemiological expertise, unquote. So there again, so you can't write about something if you don't know about it. You just don't. You don't write about things you don't understand and you don't know about. And there's a wonderful meme out, it's like, so there are all these experts and epidemiologists saying, you know, how bad the virus is and that it's dangerous and it's contagious and we got to be careful. But then you've got all these other people who, you know, wrote an article or read something somewhere and they're saying, oh, it's not such a bad thing. And the meme concludes with, we don't know who to believe anymore, expert epidemiologists or someone who read an article one day. I mean, this is where we're at, where people who have been looking at this for decades and not just reading a blog or reading an article online or Googling something, these are people who have dedicated their lives to the scientific research of epidemiology, viruses, health. And you are just a person who typed Google, "What is this going to do to my body?" That's it. You don't know anything. You don't know crap. And really, that's the whole point. The whole point is people, the majority of people, don't know crap. And we do have to depend on experts. We do. We just do. You don't go to the plumber to get your heart checked. You go to a cardiologist. Or maybe you don't. Maybe you Google it and now you're a cardiologist expert. I don't know. Maybe that's the way it's going to go in this country. And that's probably why this country is going down the tubes very quickly. So yeah, that's really, I think that trusting experts is not a bad idea, especially when it comes to serious things like our health. So I have an interesting bone to pick with my sister, who says I'm Antifa, and she's right. I am Antifa, and what Antifa means is anti-fascist. And I have been anti-fascist since I was a little girl and was told stories of what fascists did in my father's country of Greece. In fact, I always thought my sister was anti-fascist as well, because she grew up hearing the stories as well. So now all of a sudden, Antifa, being anti-fascist, has some kind of weird, mysterious connotation to it with people who subscribe to Trump. And they don't really know what it means anymore. Or maybe they're being disingenuous. So the reason I say disingenuous is Trump is a fascist. What is fascism? Let's look. The definition of fascism, according to Merriam-Webster: a political philosophy, movement, or regime, such as that of the fascisti, that exalts nation and often race above the individual, and that stands for a centralized autocratic government headed by a dictatorial leader, severe economic and social regimentation, and forcible suppression of opposition. That's the first one. The second one is a tendency toward or actual exercise of strong autocratic or dictatorial control. Pretty much a brutal dictator. The Italian origin of fascism, it means a bundle, the word fascist. And it was symbolized by a bundle of rods with an axe on them, which they used as a symbol of the Italian people united and obedient to the single authority of the state. So here we go, united and obedient. So we go back to that law and order kind of thing that we're hearing from Trump. From at least 1872, fascio was used in the names of labor and agrarian unions, and in October of 1914, a political coalition was formed called the Fascio Rivoluzionario d'Azione Internazionalista, the Revolutionary Group for International Action, which advocated Italian participation in World War I on the side of the Allies. Members of this group were first called fascisti in January 1915, although Mussolini was closely associated with this interventionist movement, it had no direct link with the post-war fasci di combattimento. And in 1919, the word fascista was already in political circulation. And it is, however, to the fascisti in their 1919 incarnation, who seized power in Italy 3 years later, that we owe the current customary meanings of our words fascism and fascist. So now I'm going to combine a story about masks and Antifa. apparently that's what we do these days. We combine the stories, two things that have nothing to do with each other. So for example, here's what happened this morning. My sister posted an article about the CDC study that actually showed that wearing masks does work, except for people who go out to eat a lot, and they have to take their masks off, exposing them and others to COVID viruses. But that's not how the Federalist read the article or read the study. And the Federalist basically just had a big headline that says, this is proof, this is dead on proof that masks don't work. Why are you wearing them? And of course, this follows with the Trump, you know, agenda that wearing masks is for stupid people, or, you know, those who are gullible enough to believe science. So very interesting. So the headline is, what this article in the Federalist's Center for Disease Control report released in September shows that masks and face coverings are not effective in preventing the spread of COVID-19, even for those people who consistently wear them. But what the article left out was the actual summary of the study, which was that wearing masks works except for people who go out to dinner a lot and take the masks off. And during that time when they're drinking beer and eating their wings, that is when the COVID gets to be spread and shared. And interestingly enough, that is absolutely what we're seeing across the board, all over the country. You know, people who are going to the bars and restaurants are getting COVID. And they might be wearing masks the whole time everywhere else they go, but when you sit down to eat, you gotta take your mask off. That's just the way it is. And I got COVID because I opened the front door and I wasn't wearing a mask, stupidly. And neither was the guy out there, and he wasn't wearing a mask. And so I got it. I mean, it's like, that's what's gonna happen. It's highly contagious. And for people who have underlying health conditions, you got to be careful around them. You can't give them this stuff. They're older than 60. These are underlying health conditions that put people at a higher risk. And if you think that you're not wearing a mask is somehow like you're right, you're endangering other people. The wearing a mask is not just to protect you, it's to protect other people. So here's what I get from my sister, who posts this article this morning, claiming that, see, masks don't work, which is complete bullshit. I shared two articles that were actually, you know, science-based, that explained why the Federalist article was wrong. And what the CDC was actually saying was that masks work, except when you go out to dinner and you take your mask off, and you're going to have a higher rate of getting this disease. So what does she say? What's her response? This coming from an Antifa supporter, please go away and stay off my Facebook page or I will block you. That's fine. You've blocked me before. I don't have a problem with people blocking me. But I think it's funny that being an Antifa supporter means there's something wrong with me. I'm sorry. When was fascism a good thing? You do know that being anti-fascist is what we should all be striving to be. Being anti-fascist is a family tradition. My family lived under Nazi occupation, and Nazis were fascists. So we don't want to like keep encouraging that. This is not right. Let's just put it that way. It's not right. So she continues, since my older sister feels the need to comment on my Facebook page on her post that she shared publicly, and my job as an educator is to educate people, so I shared a scientific study and I shared a professor's explanation of the article and why journalists need to take a course in statistics. And so she says, please be aware that she is an avid Antifa supporter. I don't just support Antifa. I am Antifa. I am anti-fascist. I don't know how that's a bad thing. Supports the killing of cops. That's not true. Ever have I ever supported the killing of cops. And supports BLM. I don't know if she means the Bureau of Land Management or Black Lives Matter, but I definitely support my black friends, my brothers and sisters of color, and people who are immigrants into this country, like my father, who is an immigrant. I definitely support them against any kind of racism or marginalization. Anything that would dehumanize people, like calling them illegal. So humans aren't illegal. There are certain statutes that very rich white men set up and create boundaries for people to move around the world safely and with dignity. And those are things that we need to address. I definitely support Black Lives Matter. The Bureau of Land Management, not so much. Yeah, they've kind of not been so great. And she says, now you know the rest of her story. Actually, you don't really know anything about me from what she says right there, because you don't know that I write music, and you don't know that I'm pagan, and you don't know that I love dancing and yoga and aikido, and I have three kids, and they're all adults, and they're amazing artists and the coolest people you would ever meet. She also doesn't mention that I support a woman's human right to control her fertility and her body. So really, that's not the rest. She doesn't mention any of this here. There's so much more, but I won't go there. Let me see. Either that was the rest of the story, or there's so much more. I don't know. Maybe she's confused, but that's okay. She's often confused. She says also, her Facebook page is so toxic and gross, and her followers are just as nuts. It's sad, but unfortunately, she is gullible and believes her own garbage. Yeah, that's true. I do have a lot of toxic and gross stuff on my page because I'm all about defending human rights and awareness and raising people's awareness of discrimination and racism, bigotry, misogyny. Those things are really gross and toxic, and if we ignore them, they just get worse. So yeah, it can be really ugly. When you're trying to pull out a cancerous growth, it's ugly, it's gross, it's toxic. But you can't just keep putting the makeup over all those things and pretending they're not there, because then it'll fester and it'll turn into a giant Trump head. And you really don't want that. What else? I have never supported the killing of cops, and I never will. I think human life is precious, and I think people who have the ability to grow emotionally, intelligently, psychically, spiritually, whatever, people have the right to develop the connection between their brainstem and their spinal cord and grow as human beings. And cops definitely have an issue. They are problematic because they have been supported and encouraged to be violent in this country. Why? Why did we go from talking about masks to talking about Antifa? Because I corrected her with facts, and we can't stick on to facts. We can't stay with the science, and we can't stay with evidence, because evidence proves the Trump story wrong every single time. So what do? We throw in these red herrings and we distract. And when you're in a conversation with somebody like that, and they distract and they throw in red herrings, well, you're Antifa, well, you're this, well, the focus was masks. Do the masks work or do they not work? It's basic science. So we look at Taiwan. Taiwan has had seven deaths. What did they do? They all wore masks, they social distanced, and guess what? They never shut their businesses down. And you know what? They've pretty much taken care of COVID at this point. I don't think the American citizens are going to ever be able to do that because we have too many knuckleheads out there who don't appreciate science, they don't appreciate education, they don't appreciate expertise, and they think that if they can Google it, that they become an instant overnight expert on it. And guess what? That's not true. You're not an expert.